London. The streets are abustle with horse-drawn carriages and wagons as traders cry their wares. Rich folk and humble pick their way across the teeming thoroughfares, and the crossing sweepers are hard at work scooping up behind the more nervous pedestrians. For this is the London of yesteryear, of Queen Victoria, the London of Charles Dickens. As usual, it is Christmas. The spirit of goodwill is in the air, and in Portland Place, the crowds marvel at a public display of sound effects. The shops are crammed with festive merchandise, and as dusk falls and the gas is lit, the bright windows are soon all aglow as the excited crowds impede the progress of the fire brigade.
Make way, or you'll feel the weight of my shiny helmet.
No, we like a good fire, we do.
That's why we're excited.
But come away, dear listener, away from the cheery lights and merry throng, away to this dismal street, where we find a gloomy shopfront identified in grimy lettering as the Music Emporium. Although it is Christmas, the establishment shows no sign of festivity, and within its dank interior, sitting muttering to himself at his miserable desk, we find the proprietor. None other than Ebenezer Scrumph.
Christmas? Don't talk to me about Christmas.
Yes, I wasn't talking to you.
If you're not going to buy anything, get out of the shop.
Never had this trouble with Harry Potter. Anyway. Oh, yes. One dusty corner of the premises is labelled Piano Department. And at the piano sits Scrump's penniless clerk, Colin Crotchet. Dressed in shabby clothes and thin as a rake, Colin is very poor.
So you've heard him play.
Can I have the rest of the day off, please, Mr. Scrumph?
What?
Colin was too poor even to have his own microphone.
Rest of the day off? No. But you can take a short break.
Oh, thank you.
Right, back to work. We have business to do. Look, customers.
Hello, Scrumph.
Nice to see you,
Scrumph.
Oh, it's Tim, Barry and Graham. I didn't expect the three wittiest men in all London. And how right I was. What do you want?
We are set upon purchasing some music we can play.
Then let me direct you to Mr. Crotchet. Incidentally, it may interest you to know that Colin has recently returned from a tour of Mexico where everyone was talking about his sheet music.
Tell me, Scrumph, do you have a wide selection of popular melodies?
Yes, but here at the Emporium we only specialise in sheet music. So, customers, I'd like you to come up with the titles of cut-price versions of songs that might appeal to a penny-pinching old misery guts like myself. Customer Tim, will you start, please?
Would you possibly have a copy of Tea for One by Miser Linnelli?
Do you have Come and Look at the Window Box, Maud? Or I just called to say you owe me. Or I dreamt I dwelt in Marble Arch. By chance, do you have a 7 and 6 trombone? Or my old man said cancel the van.
Swing low, sweet Caricot.
How much is that doggy in the skip?
What luck. I don't have any of them. But before you go, was it you lot who spilt a gallon of black paint just outside the shop entrance?
A gallon of black paint?
Over outside the shop.
Oh, dear. Yes, it was. I'm so sorry. Yeah,
sorry.
Well, be off with you. And never darken my doorstep again.
How are we going? Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Ah, peace at last.
Can I put a piece of coal on the fire?
No. You'll fill the shop with smoke.
That's because the chimney wants cleaning.
I'm not paying the chimney sweep to shove another boy up there. Use your big brush.
Right,
huh? Oh, yes. Oh, mind that brush.
Oh, steady.
Well, there's your problem. It's full of chimney boys.
Can I get them out?
No. Wait till somebody wants to buy a boy band. Oh, what fresh hell is this? Carol singers? And am I to suppose you're going to accompany them?
I am.
Oh, well, all right, as long as they don't sound Christmassy. Tell them they'll have to sing the words of one carol to the tune of something else. Let's try the words of Silent Night to the tune of Tequila.
Music died away. Scrumph stood for a moment with a contented smile upon his face, then took out the earplugs.
Season's greetings to you, Uncle Scrumph.
The unexpected visitor was Scrumph's nephew Fred, a tall, jolly-faced, ebullient young man in jovial mood. Fred had a prosperous look about him, having made his fortune from the sales of his travel book, Around Iceland in a Fridge.
What do you want, nephew?
I've come to invite you to join the family for our Christmas jollifications.
Can't think of anything worse. Yes, I can. Swanee Kazoo.
Come now, Uncle, you'll enjoy it. This year we're having a grand Christmas ball at the city's trendiest nightclub, the Bar Humbug.
Bar Humbug? Christmas.
The party wouldn't be the same without you, Uncle Scrumph. Is it true that you keep a trumpet locked away in a cupboard which you never, ever play in public?
Yes.
Good. In that case, you'd be more than welcome. And I can promise you a goose.
Tempting. But my housemaid Samantha takes care of that sort of thing.
The lovely Samantha. Where is the little temptress?
She's just popped out to get the price of a meal in exchange for a fiddle. Then as soon as she gets back, she's promised Colin to polish his upright.
Busy girl.
Yes, and on a Thursday she works the Strand as an organ grinder.
Yes, well, we get the picture. Well, why not bring her with you to the party?
I'm not coming to your party. Christmas? I hate Christmas and everything about it. Be off with you. You too, Crotchet. I'm going to bed in disgust.
Surely not.
You haven't seen the bed.
And so, in a foul mood, Scrumph made his way upstairs to his frugal chamber, where he soon found himself between the sheets.
Ah, there I am.
But sleep, like laughs, would not come easily that night. And as the clock began to strike midnight, he sensed a presence in the room.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.